is trying to keep the paddle blade pretty much vertical as she comes through the stroke. Now, the one thing you really want to avoid when you're paddling is when you come back, spread the stroke with the stroke cap. So you're out here, and you're landing the blade in the water and initiating the stroke. Got one component of your force that's lifting the boat up out of the water. You're pushing down on the water, lifting the boat up, getting it up to the plane a little bit more. Very important when you have a train to go up around the water as you move forward. Then when you come down farther into the stroke, you get more of the effort of your stroke is pushing straight backwards. What you're really doing is you're planting the paddle and then trying to get a feeling like it's stuck out there in the sand. So pulling the paddle back from the water, what you're doing is you're pulling the boat forward towards the paddle. The thing you want to avoid is the back of the stroke going so far back, you're putting effort in that here. And what you're doing is you still have open stroke and pulling the boat forward, but you're also pulling down. That's pulling the boat down in the water, creating more friction and kind of counter what you're trying to accomplish. So what you're really trying to focus on is kind of an arc on the stroke, okay? So you reach out, you've got this first part of the stroke where you're pushing down, and as you're pushing down, you're actually almost trying to push the paddle forward a little bit. What you don't want to get is a slapping motion. You want to get good solid tip contact, pressure on the tip. It's almost like you're lifting yourself up all the way forward with your foot on that boat. Pull that paddle down in the water, get a good stroke backwards, and when you're doing that, with a combination of rotating the board and rotating the hips and pushing with your legs. And I'll show you the position of the boat here in a minute. When you get back to about this point, you just need your knee, your mid-thigh, as far back as you can get with the paddle vertical, then you're not powering anymore. The momentum of water is going to carry your paddle blade back a little bit as you exit, but you don't want to be pushing on the stroke when you get back. That's why you want to stroke is out here, and then you're lifting and pulling back forward with the next catch. You want to concentrate on, if you're doing that, you'll have both feet planted straight forward. You want to use your legs a lot, I'll show you in the boat how to do that. You want to have a twist to the floor, okay? Actually, go into the chair. Okay, so if I drag it over here, you want your hips, depending on which side you're, right up against the edge of the boat, okay? Your weight, you want pretty much outside the boat. As you're paddling, you want to be looking right down the gunwale. Never want your weight wobbling back and forth coming into the boat. Put it outside. And as you're coming forward for that catch, while both feet planted forward, so it's outside hip, just a little bit forward from the back end. Give you extension. Then you want to stack your shoulders. Try and keep this top arm as extended as you can. Not totally locked. That's not a very anatomically good position to be in. You want just a little bit of flex, which you want both the top arm and the bottom arm extended as far forward as you can. Good tip pressure. What you're focusing on is actually pushing forward a little bit more at the start of the catch. So if you don't do that, you tend to deploy back as you're in the water. And it gives you that slapping motion and defeats a lot of that first part of the stroke. It's very effective if you've got that paddle all the way up. Get that good tip pressure. And as you're coming back, you're doing a couple of things. You're pushing with this leg, twisting at the core here, and you're rotating your shoulder. See, I've got my shoulder snapped here. This shoulder is kind of up above this shoulder. It's not totally exaggerated, but you want both your hands outside the boat. You want to be looking down the edge of the boat, and you want this hand on top of this hand. You want your paddle vertical in this plane. Then as you come back, you want your paddle to come to the point where it's vertical in this plane as well, front to back, and accomplish the rest of the stroke by pushing with the leg, twisting with the hips, turning the shoulders. There are all those components in there. This, you're trying to sit up without pushing the legs. A lot of times what you'll do is you'll pull back with your paddle and then you're sitting up to follow and you'll end up with the paddle back here with the wrong orientation of the water pulling that pulling down. You want to make sure that you're sitting up as the paddle comes back so that you keep that paddle blade pretty much vertical. Okay?
Then
you're using your whole body. You know, what you want to do is avoid using the little muscles. You don't want to be pulling with the bicep. You'll use the little muscles. What you're going to do is you're going to get very tired very fast. Some really athletic teams can do that for a little while and do pretty well. But if you're going 500 meters, 1,000 meters, whatever, pretty soon those little muscles are going to get tired. So what you're doing is using your legs, using your more, turning shoulders, turning down here, nice low down. Another thing we kind of concentrated on a little bit, it worked really well for the team that we were paddling up there. We had a group of women, the world-class athletes from Canada, but in the last competition, we were up against a group of very athletic men. Much bigger, much stronger, you know, a lot of beef in that boat. And our strategy was to understroke them. If we crank them, you know, fairly fast waves, we want to get a really good start off, come off flat really well, and then just try and have a lot more power than stroke, but not stroke so fast, you know, more at the end. That's a really good strategy, you know, in that particular race. And I think that's been a really good strategy for our team as a whole. We've got, you know, some people that are a little more on the older side that maybe not quite as athletic as some of the teams we race against. But we've been focusing over the last couple of years very successfully, I think, on developing a really good efficient stroke. And this camp's going to help us get even closer to a very efficient stroke. And also, not paddling too fast, getting good power in everyone. And when we get down towards the end, instead of having to be like, ching, being all tired out, we've got most of that foot right from the end.
Patience.
Yeah, patience. One other thing that they were really focusing on is the exit. And the exit and preparing for the next catch is very important, but there are kind of different ways of accomplishing it, and it's not as important as the stroke itself. Now, as long as you get from point A to point B in an efficient manner and be well set up for the next stroke, you know, there are various ways to get there, okay? One thing that they were talking about, you don't want to bring your hand clear in the boat, you don't want to let your paddle clear out the water. It's much more efficient to come back to just bring your paddle weight up far enough to clear the water to get over it and be ready for that next catch, rather than come up here, pinch a bird with your elbow, bring your paddle clear up above in a big arcing motion. Now, it's a small motion forward. If you've got the T-shaped paddles, a lot of our practice paddles aren't that quick, so we'll have to kind of adjust. But once we get out the boat, we'll have more of the T paddles. I'm gripping with the thumb under here, not gripping tight. The bottom hand is just kind of rolling, guiding the pedal to come through the water. We're pushing down with this one to keep it in the water. When you exit, lifting with that thumb. Lifting that thumb when you come out. And bring it over. If you're on the right side of the boat, you'll be bringing it out at about the 10 o'clock position. About 2 o'clock, if you're on the other side of the boat, just kind of lift as you take the paddle forward. Good extension, and catch on the next stroke, okay? A little embellishment from a couple of Canadians we were talking about, you know, kind of problem lifting up straight forward and then slapping the water, then slapping a wave as you come forward. One thing that you may want to work on as you get more comfortable with your stroke is a little bit of a, like, flipping a frisbee motion as you come out. They're feathering their paddle as they come forward, so it's kind of slicing out the water so you weren't catching all that resistance trying to get the paddle out of the water, slicing the wall. So they're lifting up and just taking a flipping frisbee out there to be ready to catch. Another point to make is make sure that your stroke is good and powerful and don't laze around the far end. Don't stroke here and it takes the time to get the paddle out of the water. Back and the way the paddle behind you, you're going to have to hurry to get up here. Really important thing to do is set up so you've got a really good catch in front of the stroke. Okay, you want to really be leaning forward and expect your flexibility and strength allowed. Put that upper hand, you know, out over the other hand, and straighten up as much as you comfortably can, and planting that blade out in the water with good temper in. To do that, but never say, if you bring the paddle back and come up here, not really a pause, but it almost feels like a pause before your catch. A nice powerful stroke, you come forward, and there's just that moment where you're leaning forward just a little bit more and pushing forward just a little bit more to set up for that good catch. Just a nice, synchronized focus on setting up